Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome to today's vlog. If you paid attention in the last video, this is picking up where the last video left off. So we've got the snowmobile here. Right now we're just focusing on the tunnel back here, but we got it pretty much all wire-wheeled down to the point where it's ready to paint. Like I said before, this is not going to be I'm not concerned with a flat paint job or anything like that. I just want this sled to look nice, a lot nicer than it did, because it was definitely really rusty. It still is. So I just want to get some paint on it and make it look nice, stop the rust, and be able to turn what was debatably a pile of junk into something that is a lot of fun. My purpose of this video series is that I want to show you guys that you can have a lot of fun and it doesn't involve a lot of money either. With that, I'm gonna stop talking. We're gonna get right into painting. All right, so we're just gonna be using Rust-Oleum Gloss Black. I use this stuff, and carburetor cleaner. I can never have enough of it. I just always am using it, just because of how versatile it is. Pretty much goes on any project. So we're just gonna get right into it. So, like I mentioned in the other video, it's very cold today, so hopefully that doesn't hurt me too much, but we'll see. It's supposed to be in the 50s tomorrow, which would be really nice for painting, but if this doesn't turn out nice, I'm not concerned about it. It's not really that big of a deal, because it's a snowmobile, so if it runs, it drips, it's totally fine. That's not my concern, and yeah, so I think it looks already a lot better now that it's not rusty, and we're just going to take the can to the rest of it. So I know smoked out headlights and taillights are the new thing right now, but that is one thing this snowmobile is not going to get. So before we start painting here, we're going to make sure we've got a healthy amount of painter's tape on it. So we got it all masked off. That one. bottom, stuff this in here, and now off to just put in a really light coat. I've learned my lesson. When it's cold, you have to go even lighter than usual. That, let that dry, tack up, and we'll get to the second coat. So we are going to end up painting something that I wasn't really sure of painting before, but I just did a little test spot. I really like how it turned out. So, and yes, that's even with bad painting skills, I liked how it turned out. But this right here, the I don't even know what you want to call it, but it's basically plastic molding. Is faded. It used to be black, but it's faded pretty much to white at this point. So, on that side, I cleaned it up with some steel wool, and then painted it black, and I really like how it turned out. So, I went ahead and started masking things off that I didn't want paint on, and yeah, everything else is going to get painted. Got to blow this out with my air compressor, because there's junk up in there. Clean all this out. This is the watch glass for the oil reservoir, but on this sled, someone deleted it, so you just mix the gas and oil up in the regular tank. But needless to say, this, we'll tape that off because I don't want to get paint on it in case somebody wants to go put it, hook up the oil tank again. You do want to see how much oil you have. So I'm going to clean this up, clean this back piece up, and then paint it all black. I wasn't really going for the, like, a all-black sled. The other one's red, spoiler alert. But, yeah, I think it's just going to look a lot cleaner if I do all this. So, yeah, I'm not going to waste any more time. I'm going to get into that. Like I said before, we're just going to do a quick little once-over with some steel wool. Clean up the area. Scratch it up a little bit. And then, get ready to paint. Oh, there goes my masking tape. But yeah, here's an idea just to show you how much it faded. Now, here, we'll blow it off with this leaf blower here. Grab some tape. Not too crazy here. Because, as I keep mentioning, I'm not going to worry about paint and being perfect on this one. This project is all for fun. Let that sit, tack up, and then go for another coat. But as you guys can probably see, it looks a lot better. And I'm also going to be doing a whole new seat for this, new seat foam and new seat cover. And due to, I want to keep this low budget, and also the fact that I'm on a time constraint, I'm going to be making it because the old seat has been without a cover, and so it's not really that. I don't want to spend the money to put new fabric on it and then not, have moisture rot through it. So, we're going to pick up new foam today, new plastic leather, so it can withstand the elements. But I'm definitely thinking, because this sled, I don't really want to close it, but you guys can see maybe, it's got purple and pink on it. So I think it'd be really cool to put a purple seat on it, actually. Or a black seat with, like, purple straps that go across. Because I have to figure out a way to anchor the seat down, since it's going to be slightly different than it was before. But that's just little stuff. Really happy with how it's coming along right now so far, because it was definitely looking a lot rougher this morning. So I'm going to let this tack up, get to painting again, finish cleaning up that. But I think you guys have seen enough pain for today. So with that, I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, definitely leave us a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, definitely consider subscribing and stay tuned for more content, not only with just the snowmobiles, but with other machines.